Next is 14B22. The following question is taken from December 2012 exam. A company uses a standard absorption costing system. The following figures are available for the last accounting period in which actual profit was 108,000. So actual profit was 108,000 actual. Sales volume profit variance adverse. Sales volume profit variance. अभी मुझे अगर ये सारा कुछ ना भी पता हो, मैं सिर्फ इसको देखू ना. सो इफ आई ओनली, इफ आई डोंट हैव दीज थिंग्स एंड इफ आई ओनली सी दिस वन, आई नो एक्चुअल प्रॉफिट इज 108 एंड आई नो दैट माय प्रॉफिट वेरियंस इज 6,000 एडवर्स. इट मींस दैट माय स्टैंडर्ड प्रॉफिट शुड हैव बीन मोर, माय एक्चुअल प्रॉफिट इज लेस, दैट इज व्हाई इट इज एडवर्स. ओके, सो जस्ट रीडिंग द क्वेश्चन. Sales price variance 5,000 favorable. If I add subtract this, which give me 1,000 adverse, standard profit should have been 109,000. Total variable cost variance 7,000 adverse, fixed cost expenditure variance 3,000 favorable, fixed cost volume variance 2,000 adverse. What was the standard profit for the actual sales in the accounting period? That based on the actual sales, how much profit you should have made? Now that is interesting question. See, what you need to do, you have the end result. This is your actual profit. And they ask you that how much it should have been. So if I consider these adverse and favorable variances, I can find out how much it should have been. For example, you have to go backward, okay? You say from budgeted profit to actual profit, etc. But start, just put some numbers here. Very simple. 108,000 you made. This is your actual profit. And you know that actual profit is not at par. There are some variances as well. And they ask you that if you consider the variances, how much profit you should have made. It is 108,000. So the first variance here is sales volume profit variance. Sales volume profit variance. You just ignore this one. Because why I'm saying ignore? Because it's about volume. And I'm going for actual sales. So when you are going for actual, you are not related to volume. You only talk about the actual. So I just ignore this 6,000. Then I have this sales price variance, which is $5,000. And let me write down here price variance. And this price variance is $5,000 favorable. If it is $5,000 favorable, it means that my actual is 108. So what should we do with this? It is favorable, which means that it is more. It is more. In standard, it should have been less. Because it is favorable, let me write down here that this variance, price variance, it is favorable. It is favorable. I will subtract here because I say that 108, this 5,000 I made more. In standard, it should have been less. So favorable means that in actual you made more. So standard was less. That's why you call it favorable. So you subtract it. Then you have your next variance, which is variable cost variance. And variable cost variance is 7,000 and it is adverse. It is 7,000, I will add. Favorable, I will subtract, and adverse, I will add. Then I have my fixed cost expenditure variance, okay? Expenditure variance is again favorable. It is 3,000 favorable. And 3,000 favorable, I should again subtract. And then I have fixed cost volume variance, okay? Fixed cost volume variance. And this volume variance is adverse. If it is adverse, I should be adding it. And that is $2,000. Just make a total. 109,000. Your profit should have been. should have been. You only need to understand which one you should minus, which one you should plus. Favorables you should minus, adverse you should add. And why do you do that? Let me tell you. Okay, the question is done. Answer is 109,000. Let me tell you. Let's suppose that you have, let's create some numbers. Okay, let's create some number. Your standard fixed cost, let's call it standard fixed cost or standard variable cost. Let me write down in your terminology. You say that variable cost should have been, let's suppose 10,000. But then you say that variable cost actually was 12,000. So if cost is more, you say it is 2,000 and you call it adverse. Okay. You say that my variable cost was more. So I call it an adverse variance. This is what you say. Now they only give you this answer that your variable cost variance is adverse 7,000. Okay. Let me do it like this 17,000. Okay. So it comes out to be this much. So when I say my cost is adverse, it means that I spent more. When you spent more, your profit was less. If it had not been adverse, your standard profit should have been more. Listen, when I say my cost is adverse, what does that mean? It means I spent more. In reality, I spent more than how much I should have. So if you are spending more, your profit is less. So if you see here, variable cost is adverse. When it say adverse 7,000, it means that you wrote down extra cost 7,000 and therefore your profit is less. So if you want to see that if this variance had not been there, how much it should have been, then you add this 7,000 on top of that. You say my profit should be 108 plus 7, $115,000. So just need to do one or two such questions and then it will become much more clear. Then comes 14B23. What was the budgeted profit for the last month? Budgeted profit, not the actual, but budgeted. Okay. The following question is taken from the July to December 2013 exam period. A company uses a standard absorption costing system. Last month, the actual profit was 500,000 actual, and we have to find out budgeted. The only variances recorded for the month were as follows. Sales, volume, profit variance, $10,000 adverse. These are thousands. Fixed production overhead capacity variance, 30,000 favorable, 40,000 adverse, 10,000 adverse, fixed production overhead volume variance. Fixed production overhead expenditure variance. So fixed production overhead expenditure, volume, efficiency, capacity. And direct labor efficiency variance, 15,000 adverse. So how much your answer should be? Now that's again a very typical question like before. You should find out the budgeted profit, which means how much you actually planned for. You have been given the actual one. Okay, we'll do it the same way like we did before, but you should pay attention that there are many fixed overhead variances and this will confuse you. You remember that your capacity variance and efficiency variance, these two variances, they actually together make volume variance. Always remember your fixed overhead variances are of two types. Here you've got expenditure variance and here you have volume variance, and within volume you have capacity and you have efficiency. So you cannot take this one like 30 and then 40 and then 10. Either you take 40 and these two or you take this one. You cannot take all of them because these two are inside of that. If you pay attention, they are telling you here, what they are telling you that your fixed overhead capacity variance is 30 favorable. So it is 30 favorable. And then your efficiency variance is 40 adverse. It is 40 adverse. And the net result of these two, 30 favorable and 40 adverse, volume is 10 adverse. Okay. So either you just take this number, I will only take this number. Either you take this one or you can take these two. So if you want to use this one and this one, then you must ignore this. But I would rather ignore these two and I will just take 10 adverse. This is the only thing you need to pay attention. So where we start from, we have got our actual profit. Actual profit, which is, you know, 500,000. And then you've got variances. For example, you have sales volume profit variance. Okay. And it is sales volume profit variance is 10 adverse. So it is adverse. I'll add back 10,000. Then I have my, say, my fixed overhead. I will just take one number. Fixed overhead, volume variance. Volume variance is also adverse. It is 10,000. I will add this one also. So what I've done, this we did. Capacity we just will ignore. We don't need it. Efficiency we will ignore. This I have done. So these two we have written. And then we do fixed production overhead expenditure variance 50 favorable. So you have fixed overhead expenditure variance. And this is your favorable. And it is 50,000. So favorable you will subtract. And then you have direct labor efficiency variance. Labor efficiency variance. Labor efficiency variance. How much is that? It is adverse. And it is 15,000. So if it is adverse, it is 15,000. I will add. By the way, there was favorable. I should subtract. This one I should minus. Okay. 50,000 I should minus. And you make a total of that. There is no other variance. Yes. Just make a total. 485,000 should be your answer. 485 here. This one. Just not confuse with these two. Ignore these two. Students sometimes make mistake here. Now comes this 14B24. The following question is taken from the January to June 2014 exam period. Which of the following is a valid combination of the three variances? Sales volume profit variance, sales price variance, direct material price variance. Okay. The company uses a standard absorption costing, So sales volume profit margin variance. Actual profit last year was 25,000, which was 5,000 less than the budgeted profit. So profit was less. The standard profit on actual sales for the period was 15,000. Standard profit on actual sales, which means that profit should have been 15,000. You made 25. But it should have been based on your actual sales. It should have been 15. So you are doing good actually. Only three variances occurred in the period. A sales volume profit variance, a sales price variance, and a direct material price variance. Which of the following is a valid combination of the three variances? Okay, very simple question. You just need to pay attention to numbers. They told us that our actual profit was 25,000. Okay. And they said that which is 5,000 less than the budgeted profit. So it means that your budgeted profit was 30,000. We can assume, because it said that actual profit was 25. Remember your operating statement. You start with the budgeted profit and actual profit, the difference between them. How do you make operating statement? You start with your, you know, budgeted profit. You say my budget profit is 100,000. And then you go down and down and you say that my actual profit is, I don't know, 80,000. So the difference between these two, 100 and 80, the difference between the actual and budget profit, it is because of these variances. And in between are all these variances. So the sum total of all these variances should be equal to 20,000. I mean, the difference between budgeted and actual profit is 20. And the sum total of all the variances should be 20,000. This was our logic. Now in our exam, in our example, actual is 25, budgeted was 30. So there is a difference of 5,000. So all the variances, because they said that these are the only three variances, there is no other variance. So the sum total of these three variances should be 5,000. This is first you should understand. Now, if I say, let's make sum total, it is 15 adverse, 2 favorable, 8 favorable, 8 plus 2, 10, and it is 5 adverse. So this is coming 5,000, it is adverse. So this could be my answer. This could be my answer. I'm not saying this is the answer, but it is giving me 5,000 adverse. I am looking for 5,000 adverse. When I see this B option, 5,000 adverse, 2,000 adverse, 2,000 favorable. It also gives me 5,000 adverse. When you see this third one, 15,000 adverse, 2,000 adverse, it makes 17,000. It gives me 25,000 adverse. This cannot be my answer. Then 5,000 adverse, 5,000 favorable, 5,000 adverse. This also is giving you 5,000 adverse. So it has to be A, B, and D. C is gone. So first you need to understand that it has to be 5,000 here. But then we go to the another condition. They told you that the standard profit on actual sale for the period was 15,000. The standard profit on actual sales for the period was 15,000 standard profit. Now you have a budgeted profit, which is 30. You have actual, which is 25. And you have a standard, which is 15. Standard is 15,000. So if I see the difference between budgeted and standard is because of the sales volume. So how much is the difference? So you have a sales volume profit margin variance of 15,000. You have a $15,000 adverse because according to your calculation, it should be 30, but you are only getting 15. So you have a 15,000 sales volume profit variance adverse, which is your option A. This should be your answer. Clear?
Okay.